I'm Jeff Altman, the Big Game Hunter. I coach people. I do career and leadership coaching. I'm the head coach for JobSearchCoachingHQ.com and NoBSCoachingAdvice.com. When I worked in recruiting, I negotiated a lot of deals. I think the final tally was, I know it was more than 1,200 full-time jobs plus consulting assignments. And often when I would be negotiating for people, often when I was negotiating for an employer, because that's the truth of it, you may be presenting yourself as negotiating for the job hunter, but since the employer is paying, that's really who you're negotiating for. I was asked to try and get someone to accept a lesser offer. So the title of this video is, it isn't just $5,000 you're leaving on the table. And let me explain by what I mean by that. If you accept the $5,000 lower offer, often a recruiter, this wasn't one of my bits, but I heard other people do it. Often a recruiter is going to tell you, we're talking about less than $100 a week. Like maybe $98 a week pre-tax. After tax, if you're in a big tax state, maybe it's $65 or $70 a week. And this is a great opportunity for you. You love this job. Couldn't you, you know, it's such a small amount. Couldn't you take the offer so you can have a job that you really want? And if it's $10,000 less, you know, the numbers are, let's say, double. However, I just want to point something out to you, and that is your subsequent salary increases are going to be based upon your starting salary. And even if they give you a sign-on to compensate for the fact that they've offered you less, all your salary increases are going to be based upon the starting salary. So, for example, you joined for, I don't know, $100,000. And your next, you wanted 105. There's a $5,000 differential. And let's say you get a 3% increase. What you've lost in the way of money is $5,150. And then from there, what happens is you start losing some additional amounts of money after that. So each year, it's another $5,000 plus the salary increase. Excuse the noise in the background. And the result winds up being over 5 years, you've lost about $25,000, $26,000. And your raises are also going to wind up being lower from that point on. There's a loss of income to you based upon each of those years of experience, each of those additional years that you've lost the $5,000. Over the course of a career, let's say you're 25 at the time that you decide to take $5,000 less, just on the basis of taking $5,000 less and not even taking into account salary increases, that's $200,000. Can you afford to leave that on the table? Now, you may say, well, subsequent increases, I can make it up. But employers often predicate an increased salary based upon your existing one. Yes, I know there are states and locales where they're not allowed to ask you about your compensation, but functionally, they figure it out because they start to develop experiences with people who work at these firms, who have an idea, and they learn an idea of how much someone earns. You're leaving money behind. So I want to remind you, when they're trying to guilt you or shame you into accepting less money, it's not just the first year money that's involved. It's all the subsequent years of money. So I'm Jeff Altman, the Big Game Hunter. I hope you found this helpful. If you're interested in my coaching, you reach out to me through LinkedIn at linkedin.com/IN/TheBigGameHunter. Once we're connected, message me that you're interested in coaching. We'll set up a time for a short free discovery call. If you only have a couple of questions for me, there are two ways you can reach out to me. One is through an app called PrestoExperts.com, where I'm a job search and career coaching expert, or through an app called Magnify, M-A-G-N-I-F-I, which is iOS only. We can have a video chat. Both of these are pay services. Like you, I don't work for free. Have a great day. Take care.